It's incredibly comfortable. Now, what is this? This looks like I could make cocoa with this. What is that?
Well, that's an insect-based premium protein. It's made from Molitor, which is mealworm larvae. The company is called Insect. This is in France. This is for fertilizer. Mm-hmm. And as you have there, this is a powder derived from the mealworm, and it's a insect protein just been approved by the EU for human consumption.
You're not just getting me to eat dirt, are you?
No, man. I wouldn't play you, bro. We're like one entity now.
If this is protein, it's essentially tasteless. It's just a protein supplement?
Exactly.
I could put this in a smoothie or something?
I'm telling you, yep, and they'll be making all kinds of stuff out of it. And by the way, it is the making of it is severely reducing the amount of emissions it takes. It is a innovation, Justin. We're doing something incorrectly. If we make this switch, it's a huge, huge intervention.
Bruh.
Oh, fuck off.
All right, Shalom. Kahala Yahweh. Bahasham approving cricket powder, you know, and cricket powder and and who knows, many of us have probably already been consuming these kind of things added in our foods for some time now without ever knowing or refusing to know. You know what I'm saying? But that's the grim reality of it. All right? These devils have been polluting our food for years now. All right? By adding certain different types of abominations. That they're supposed to eat pork. All right? You know, but he goes on and add that pork as a substance to some of your favorite foods any damn way. All right, so that's the same thing he's doing with these insects now. All right, and in these last days, all right, now they're not trying to hide it so much no more. All right, now they are more openly coming out to convince you that it's okay to eat these creatures, these bugs, all right? You got one of your favorite all-time Marvel actors, Robert Downey Jr. Yeah, that's right, him, all right? He's one of the first ones to come out and advocate, all right? Advocate you know, for these foods to be approved and eaten by the people, man. All right. Not only is he advocating for it, but he's invested some of his own money in producing a mealworm of a factory or farm. You know what I'm saying? Just look it up on Google. All right. The bottom line is that they're even using some of these A-list celebrities, all right, to come out and tell you, all right, you the people that might be watching this show, that it's okay to eat bugs now, all right, as suggested in this article right here, all right. I got this article pulled up from Forbes.com, all right? And the headline reads, "Eat bugs, it's what's for dinner," all right? So the future is looking more and more grim in these last days, all right, on how these banksters want to rule you people out there, man. All right. Not only do they want you to wear an electronic tag called the microchip, all right? Not only do they want you to bear that MARK, all right, MOTB, all right? They also want to dictate to you what you can eat and what you can't eat. And they want you to finish off polluting your bodies, all right, by ingesting all matter of abominable insects and creepy crawlers, all right, and your damn food, man. You know what I'm saying? But before I get any more into it, I'm going to read a little bit of this article, all right? Now, it starts off by this: farming edible insects to feed people and livestock could help improve food security and support developing economies and potentially replace conventional animal feed. All right? You just heard what I said, right? I'm going to read that again. Farming edible insects to feed people and livestock could help improve food security and support developing economies and potentially replace conventional animal feed. All right? So this is the future of this country. This is the future of Babylon, all right? If the Lord don't come back and destroy it any sooner, this is part of their new world order agenda, man. This is part of their agenda. That they want to replace the current traditional meat diet, which is known as cattle meat, beef, chicken, and pork, all right, and even fish, all right. Those are the regular traditional meats, all right, that mankind has been sustaining themselves with for many years now. Now these wicked elite bankster rulers, they're pushing out this idea that insects are safe, they're edible to eat. You know what I'm saying? They want to convince you sheeple out there, all right, to forget about pork, forget about lamb, all right? And lamb happens to be the traditional meal for the coming Passover, all right? For those brothers that observe the Passover, which is next month or in April, I think. All right. So basically, they want brothers to celebrate the Passover what? Eating bugs now instead of the traditional lamb meat. You know what I'm saying? Since when did the power of the Bible ever commanded his people to only include bugs in their diet? Not ever, man. Not ever. You won't find that on any page in the Bible except in Leviticus. Except in Leviticus, which, Lord willing, I have a couple of scriptures round up. And Leviticus, with Lord willing, I'll be bringing up real shortly, which deals with the dietary laws. All right, the dietary laws that the Most High had commanded Moses, all right, to decree unto the people once they were led out of Egypt. All right, so I'm going to finish reading this article, a little bit more of this article. All right, and right there you see, I find this photograph quite gross. All right, It's quite gross. It's disgusting. All right. It might be an artist rendering. All right. But this is, hey, this is the white male's agenda for future America, man. This is part of the NWO future you're looking at right here. All right. They want you sheeple to eat insect burgers. All right. They want you to eat all insect larvae, maggots and shit like that. I'm going to keep reading on. All right. All right. So let me just read a little bit more of this madness. All right. It says this. Would you eat a mealworm pizza, a grasshopper stir fry, a cricket curry, a deep fried tarantula? This is exactly what two teams of academics propose as the main protein source for livestock and people. All right. And people, that includes you sheeple out there that might be watching this program tonight. All right. That includes you too. Not only do they want livestock, that is the current meat that we eat. Not only do they want to feed these insects to, since when is cattle or you know, pigs, on the other hand, that they can eat anything. And the Most High had commanded his people not to eat swine any damn way. But since when have cattle ever been fed anything like crickets and maggots and beetles and stuff like that? You understand what I'm saying? Since when has any other livestock been fed this, man? All right? But this is what they want, man. This is part of their 2030 agenda, man. Okay? I'm going to keep reading on. The first team of scientists, entomologist Arnold Van Huys, a professor emeritus with, however you pronounce that, university, chief editor of the Journal of Insects as Food and Feed, and co-author of several books, including cookbooks about insects as food, and food scientist Laura Gasco, a professor of animal and veterinary science at the University of Torino, argued that a strong case can be made for using insects. Note that throughout this piece, I preferred to all edible amphipods incorrectly as insects to expedite your reading. As a protein-rich feed for livestock, all right, and other food animals such as foreign fish, all right? Now, I may not have this scripture lined up to read tonight, but all right. But if I'm not mistaken, all right, in the book of Corinthians, all right, 1st or 2nd Corinthians, all right, the Apostle Paul wrote the wisdom, Paul wrote, that the wisdom of this world is foolishness with the Most High. All right? Okay? The wisdom of this world is foolishness with the Most High. So these so-called professors ain't nothing but a bunch of fools, man. All right? And straight up wicked. When they come up and tell the people that it's okay and safe to eat these creepy crawlers now, including in your diet. All right? I'm going to see if I can read a little bit more. Okay. Okay. Salakia. They're making this... they're making the page run a little slow, all right? So bear with me. Okay? It goes on to say, using insects as livestock feed can improve the sustainability of food production, because insects can transform low-value organic waste, fruits, vegetables, and even manna into high-quality livestock feed. And because what goes in must come out, the insects produce poop, no more properly as frass, which makes a superb fertilizer for plants. No shit. All right? I'm going to keep scrolling down. Insects as food are also a valuable source of nutrition for animals and has many potential health benefits. Despite the growing number of vegetarians and vegans, the global demand for meat is still accelerating. So it is critically important to develop more efficient ways to produce those animals that people are clamoring to consume. Further, Salakia, farming insects for food is likely to become more feasible as the planet continues to warm and can help support local food production networks. Okay, so there you go. All right, that's all I'm going to read on that. For those of y'all that might be interested, all right, I might leave a link later on and y'all can click on it, all right, and finish edifying yourselves and get a more heads up of where this world is headed to, man. All right. Don't be surprised if one of these days you walk into a supermarket, all right, and you're gonna see maggots, all right, or canned or packed tarantulas or grasshoppers for sale. They want to try and replace all matter of meat with these bugs, man. Okay, that is what they want. All right. That is what they want. Now let me try and close this window here. All right. There's another window that I would like to show you before I start pulling up scriptures. All right. See if I can close this window here. All right. All right, so I said I was going to show you this picture here before moving on to scriptures, all right? And this is a picture here on Google that depicts an insect burger at a, I believe it's at a German supermarket, all right? So this theme is already growing momentum in some places of Europe, all right, and Germany being one of them, all right. And here you see a white man holding a package of that reads insect burger, all right. So that means that those two patties you see right there are not made out of chicken or cattle meat. All right, nor even turkey meat. All right, they're made from mealworms, crickets, beetles, and maggots, all right? They're made from stuff like that. And this is the stuff that they're trying to push this globally. You understand what I'm saying? So I'm going to read the below section of the photograph. It says, fake meat industry, eyes crickets, beetles, mealworms, maggots for burgers. All right? So that's their way of telling you that not only do they want to replace not only do they want to replace regular burgers with these things, but the whole food chain in general. All right? That is what they're pushing for in the next few years to come. Right now, some of this is already taking place in some parts of Europe, but they want this to be all over, all right? That they want this to, they think that they could accomplish spreading this all over real soon, all right? So that's all I wanted to bring up on that. Now, let's go over the scriptures, all right? So I'm going to start with 1 Corinthians, all right? Because in the article that I read earlier, all right, a bunch of so-called nutrition experts, so-called professors of this and that, all right, were basically advocating for the idea to convince you people out there that it's okay to find creepy crawlers edible to put in your mouth and all that. All right? So here is 1 Corinthians, the words of the Apostle Paul. All right? And I'm going to read verses 18 and 19. All right? It says, let no man deceive himself. If any man among you seemeth to be wise in this world, let him become a fool, that he may be wise. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness with the Most High. For it is written, he taketh the wise in their own craftiness. All right? So let's get a precept of that real quick. Romans 1 and 22. All right? Let's go to Romans 1, 22. And then I'm going to go to Leviticus after that. All right? All right, Lord willing. So here we go. Book of Romans, the first chapter and the 22nd verse. All right. Romans 1:22. All right. Could serve as precept to what I just read. All right. Okay, here we go. Romans first chapter. I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to read the 22nd verse. All right. And what does that say? Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools. All right. So there you go. All right. Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools and changed the glory of the uncorruptible power into an image made like to corruptible man, and to birds and four-footed beasts and creeping things. All right? So that's basically that's basically same in a nutshell, all right, how the Israelites went off, all right, and worshiping idols instead of the Most High, all right, and that's one of the reasons we fell down and are living in this corruptible society, all right. Now, I'm going to go to Leviticus now to the dietary law. All right. Okay, the Leviticus, that's in the Old Testament, the 11th chapter. All right. I'm going to read verses 21 through 23. All right. Leviticus 11. All right. Okay, because some of you might find it amusing, all right, that the Most High did approve, all right, he did approve for some insects to be consumed, all right, by the Israelites back in the day. All right. If you check out the story of John the Baptist, you would know that you know his diet consisted mainly of what? Of locusts. All right. Now locusts is really another name for grasshopper or cricket. All right. That is what those things are. Yet the higher power approved that those things, that it was okay for those things to be consumed. All right. Now the way Esau and his rulership is, you know, the way he's trying to push it now is really I'm a whole nother level. All right. So I'm gonna read. Before I get any further on Esau's madness, I'm going to read the dietary law, all right, and Leviticus 11. I'm going to read these few verses, all right? I'm going to start with verse 21, all right? Leviticus 11, verse 21. Yet these may ye eat of every flying creeping thing that goeth upon all four, which have legs above their feet, to leap withal upon the earth. Verse 22, even these of them ye may eat, the locust after his kind, and the bald locust after his kind, and the beetle after his kind, and the grasshopper after his kind. So those kind of insects, all right, for some peculiar reason, all right, the Most High said it was okay, all right, it was okay for the Israelites to consume back in the ancient world, all right. The Most High gave the okay that it was edible, that those creatures were okay to consume and all that, to eat, all right? But according to verse 23, all right, but all other flying, creeping things which have 4 feet shall be an abomination unto you, all right? Verse 24, and for these ye shall be unclean. Whosoever toucheth the carcass of them shall be unclean unto them, unto the even. All right? Okay, so basically, right there it is saying that it was okay. The Most High gave the okay to eat locusts, beetles, and grasshoppers. All right? And I assume even crickets, all right? But never did the Most High mention anything about tarantulas. He never mentioned anything about eating spiders, all right? About eating maggots or mealworms, all right? And all this other madness. Esau is trying, the so-called white man is trying to push it as the okay to eat in his kingdom, all right? And he's trying to enforce the population to adapt into this new lifestyle, all right? But that's what he's striving for nowadays, all right? That's what he wants in his new world order, all right? He wants total control. And part of that control is making you people eat bugs, man. All right? To forget about regular meat, forget about your forget about going to McDonald's or Burger King, all right? Forget about Wendy's or Popeye's chicken and all that, okay? That this white man in the foreseeable future is trying to make is trying to change everything. All right. He wants to replace all the stuff that you know and is used to by now. All right. Replace the current food chain as you know it for that of bugs, of maggots, of all these. Of all these other abominations, man, that they've already been adding to your food any damn way. Okay? It is only now that they want to make it official. You understand what I'm saying? Now ask yourself a question. Why have there been so many news reports in the last few years of these food processing plants being set on fire and all that? Why they justify why so much chicken and other livestock have been put to death and all that? Okay, and all these other farming industry being destroyed. Why is that, man? Okay, why are these things happening? All right, these things are happening because it is the wicked elite that's pushing for this agenda, man. Okay, all right. The reason why cattle and chicken are being destroyed. Okay, that goes all part into their game plan and the here topic of this show tonight. Plain and simple. All right. Now, Salakia, if I have a scratchy throat, you understand what I'm saying? That's just these demons that don't want me to do this show. All right. They've been making the computer run slow as hell, and me, Salakia, me having to reboot the computer, and then you hear me coughing. I get an irritated, scratchy throat. You know that's me battling these demons here. They don't want this show to come out. All right, Salakia, about that. Now I think I can see why few of you even bother to watch my shows, cause and you know I do this effort every weekend, you know, and I push it out on YouTube, and it's really few of you that bother watching anyway. All right, but you know, hey, you keep go ahead and watch what you want to watch. You understand what I'm saying? You're not really obligated to watch my shows, okay? And I'm not trying to be like anybody. I'm trying to do the will of the Most High, period. I'm not here to try and make me cough all you want, but I'm not here trying to be famous or anything like that, all right? Or trying to be a renowned prophet. You understand what I'm saying? I'm just trying to do this here thing with the best of my ability, all right? And that's all there's to it, even if you devils don't want me to do it, all right? Okay, now, let's move on, all right? I just read Leviticus right there. I'm gonna go to Ezekiel now, and two more scriptures after that. So this ain't gotta be too long anyway. All right, Ezekiel. All right, let's go there real quick. Ezekiel 4, verse 13, all right? And it said this, and the Lord power said, even thus shall the children of Israel eat their defiled bread among the Gentiles, whether I will drive them. All right? So there you go. There you go. That's the present situation that we're in. All right. It was already prophesied, all right, by the Lord Himself that we would be living under these conditions. You know. That as long as we were to be under our enemies, they could try and do what they want with us. And right now that they're trying to enforce, okay, among their many other wicked their wicked plots, all right, for the people to eat bugs and all that. You understand what I'm saying? So I'm going to read that again. And the Lord power said, even thus shall the children of Israel, Yasha'Allah, eat their defiled bread among the Gentiles, whether I will drive them. Okay, so a lot of the current food that we eat has already been defiled any damn way. But plain and simple, all right? It doesn't matter. You know, it doesn't matter if you prefer eating vegetables, if you call yourself a vegetarian, all right? Even that is defiled by the chemicals and so-called bug spray, you know, all these insecticides alone that they be spraying on these vegetable farms any damn way. Okay? You understand what I'm saying? So, hey, the only way out of this thing is basically Abba Ratasa, that the Lord may come and pick his elect up, him coming to pick us up. You understand what I'm saying? That's the only best way out of this whole thing. All right? Okay? Now, let's go to Isaiah now. Isaiah, the 10th chapter. All right. Isaiah 10, and I'm going to read verse 1. All right. And what does that say? Isaiah 10 and 1. Woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees, and that right grievousness which they have prescribed. Okay, so right now, this whole thing going on, this famine that they're trying to bring. All right, it's not just a famine. What would they want to bring a famine into this society? And the burning down of these food plants and you see all these farm animals dying. They're killing off the cows, they're killing off the chicken, they're doing that on purpose, man. Okay? That they want to bring this famine, and in the midst of that, okay. In the midst of that, it is my guess for the spirit that their solution is going to be, look, we have a solution for you. Eat bugs, okay? Okay. Eat bugs, man. That's basically part of their wicked agenda. All right. That they want the pop. They want the whole population to eat bugs, man. Okay. Are you gonna just sit back and let these demons run over you like that? You understand what I'm saying? All right. This is why it's important to seek after the Most High, man. Okay, and to be aware of this here truth, and don't take this truth for granted, or use it as entertainment, because that's what a lot of these niggers and spicks do at the end of the day. Those that ain't really part of this thing, they just want to keep partying and bullshitting. They don't take this thing serious enough. Okay. So it is basically people like those that the devil will take more advantage out of in these last days. All right. Now, let's go to Job. I'm going to finish it there. All right. Okay. Book of Job 20 and the 23rd verse. All right. So like I've been saying all along, okay, this is all part of Esau's wicked agenda, okay? Okay, and just when he thinks that he's going to have everybody and everything under his control, all right, that's when the Most High is going to get ready and throw a monkey wrench at him. You understand what I'm saying? Like my man Anwar, the brother Anwar Gabbar, be saying, he's gonna throw a monkey wrench at him. You understand what I'm saying? That's what's getting ready to happen. That's what I'm getting ready to read here in the book of Job 20 and the 23rd chapter. Okay? So it reads this: when he is about to fill his belly, the Most High shall cast the fury of his wrath upon him and shall rain it upon him while he is eating. Okay? So our enemies, them being the banking elite, when they think that they have everything fully accomplished, all right? And I bet that they're not gonna eat bugs their damn selves. They eat the finest meat available. All right, that they have their own. They could afford to have their own farms, and their own favorite selected meat. All right, raised and cooked for them, man. That is how they live. That is real living right there. The Rothschilds and Rockefellers and all these other devils don't need to go to any damn supermarket like the rest of you sheeple out there. They don't get their food from some supermarket. All right? Plain and simple. And that's how it's going to be in the kingdom. That is the level that Lord willing, we are gonna come up next with. You understand what I'm saying? That's one of the reasons the Lord is getting ready to come back. All right, to raise us out of this present day dunghill that we're in. All right. And to be excelled, you understand? Because that was how he meant his people to be all along, to be the standard of excellence of this world. Right now, as a result of our past sins, all right, and turning our back on the Most High, all right. We've been paying for our sins. So right now, we are not no standard of excellence in this white man's world. He is. Okay? Right now, this is still his world. This is still his dominion, his authority. Okay? So they can feel free to say that they are Jews, the small hatters and all that. They have all the present day blessings. You understand what I'm saying? But it's getting ready to be taken from them real soon. All right? That's what I'm reading in this here scripture. Okay? So while he is about to fill his belly, the Most High shall cast the fury of his wrath upon him. All right? And shall rain it upon him while he is eating. While they think they are rejoicing and celebrating, that's when that sudden judgment is going to rain upon them, man. In the name of Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, man. Okay?